Today we're talking about Mother's Day, and we're starting with Mother's Day, and I'm talking with Jackie and Lois, good dear friends of mine here at the Vineyard Longmont. As women, we wanted to highlight their stories this week.
So. My name is Jackie, as you have said, and I grew up most of my life in Southeast Asia. In Malaysia specifically. My parents were students. My mom was studying her master's and my dad was studying his PhD at the time. And then they decided to have an anchor baby so that they could stay and work in the United States. It's when someone who wants to stay in a country has a baby, and because then they have to take care of the minor. My parents are both from Malaysia. And when, you know, their parents started asking them to go home, at that point, they have been living in the United States for 9 years. I was only 4 years old. And so that was kind of like the beginning of my life where I experienced, you know, four seasons and all of the stuff. It was like completely switched. And then I went back to Malaysia. And then the next 3 years kind of was more typical family structure with, like, I lived with my mom and dad and I went to school. But then my dad got into a really horrible car accident. He was actually walking and a car ran him over. And so he didn't survive that. And he passed away.
Oh, Jackie, we're so sorry. I don't know if I knew that.
Yeah. And so that was kind of like another thing that, you know, it changed again in my life where, like, okay, I'm not living with mom anymore, because mom at that time was, you know, taking care of the kids. And she then became kind of the primary breadwinner of the house. And I would see her maybe once every fourth night, once every 2 weeks. And so that was kind of the first few years of my life. And I normally say I grew up with a typically normal Asian family where, like, I lived with my cousins and I lived with my aunt and uncle, and we were all like 10, 20 people under the same roof. We would eat dinner together and, like, there would be no space, so you had to go sit at the other table. And so that is kind of my family origin, where, like, I'm used to, you know, being around my aunt, my uncle, and my cousin. But then that kind of led to a slightly more contentious relationship with my mom, because even though I knew in my head logically that, like, the reason why I don't see her a lot is because she needed to provide for me, there's still a part of me that was like, well, in my head, I really wanted my mom to be like home every day, bring me my lunch at school if I forgot it, or know all my friends. But that obviously never happened. Not because she wasn't a good mom, because she didn't have the capability to do that. She lived 5 hours away from me. So
it makes me sad. It makes me think of probably somebody who was really lonely growing up, even amidst family.
I think that led to a certain type of facade that I've put up growing up, you know, with, like, a lot of big family and everything, like, that I presented myself always, like, as this really happy, no problems, I don't have any problems, you know, because I didn't want to burden my mom, who lived like 5 hours away. I didn't want to burden my aunt, my uncle, my grandparents.
And that was kind of, were there too, your grandparents?
Yeah, my grandparents were, my grandma would cook all the time. My grandfather drove me to school and picked me up every single day of my life until I could drive.
So you must have been very close to them. And tell me what your grandmother made.
My grandmother made a lot of fish. We would eat fish every day. Fish, rice, and vegetables. Pretty much every day. Alex would probably hate it. But from time to time, we get some really yummy chicken. We'll get some pork belly seasoned with soy sauce and deep fried. It's really good. I don't know how to explain it, but it's called like fried pork. Basically, it's really good.
So after this, Jackie, we want to have some pork belly with you.
Oh boy, I'm gonna have to call grandma and ask her the recipe. It was very well taken care of by my grandparents, my mom's parents actually, but they weren't the most emotionally engaged. It was always one thing where they would see someone cry or someone show emotions and they would say like, well, we can't have that, like just get on with your day, mm-hmm. right? But then because of growing up and like, at 4 years old, things drastically change. At 7 years old, things drastically change. It has created some like really deep rooted anxiety in me, to the point where it's like I had to shove it all down and I couldn't experience any other emotion. But I was always anxious all the time. So what I ended up doing was just doing a bunch of stuff so I would distract myself from my anxiety. And so I think around the time my dad passed away, we had a funeral, and my family is kind of like split 50-50. Most of them are like Buddhist Taoist, and my aunt, one of my aunts, she was a Christian. And so during the funeral, there were these Taoist Buddhist monks who were, you know, crying and grieving and chanting. And it just seemed so, so sad, like it was the end of the world. But then, then we had the Christians who would come in, who would pray and sing. And it was very uplifting. And that was kind of my first experience with Christianity, that the Christians had such joy and peace that it was not what I was used to. And so right around then, my mom was invited to go to church, and I would go to church with my mom. And that's kind of my first experience and exposure to Christianity and finding God.